In this lecture, we are going to see extended ER features. I, Professor D.V. Kosti, welcome you for this lecture. Let us start. The contents for today's lecture are specialization, generalization, attribute inheritance, constraints on generalizations, and aggregation. So let us see one by one. So first is specialization. Now consider an entity named as person. Now we can say that an entity named as a person is a single entity, but in some cases it can be further classified as the person may be customer and the person may be employee. So depending on a particular thing, person is categorized into two different parts, that is customer and employee. So we can say that an entity is now divided into two different entities, and this process is called as a specialization, because a person is having name attribute, address attribute, and many attributes will be there, but a person cannot have customer ID and a person cannot have employee ID at the same time. Only one person cannot be customer, cannot be employee. So for that purpose, person is specialized into two different entities, customer and employee. Now here, each of these persons type is described by a set of attributes that includes, just I told you, all the attributes of entities person plus possibly additional attributes. The example is customer entities may be described further by attribute customer ID, whereas employee entities may be described further by the attributes employee ID and salary. I hope you got this. Now the definition, the process of designating subgrouping within an entity set is called as specialization. So I hope you understood, dividing an entity into two different entities that are having some special properties is called as specialization. So this diagram will make you clear. Top down approach we are going to follow. Now here you can see person is having the attributes as name, street and city. Now this person cannot have the attributes like salary and then customer ID at the same time, because we are not interested in the salary of a customer, whereas we are interested in salary of an employee. So that's why here person is a employee and person is a customer. So person can be anything out of these two. So all the attributes name, street and city are as it is for employee and customer. But one more entity is added for employee, that is salary, and for customer, that is credit rating. Further, employee cannot be employee only. Employee can be an officer, employee can be a teller, employee can be a secretary. So depending on that, whatever the attributes are there for the employee, which are inherited from the person, name, street, city and salary, there can be more categories like officer, teller or secretary. So officer's entity is increased as officer, office number. Teller's two entities are there, station number and hours worked, and secretary is one more entity that is as called as hours worked. So in short, we will say specialization is nothing but grouping of a particular entity into a particular special characteristics. That is, person is grouped into employee and customer, and employee can be further subdivided into officer, teller and secretary. I hope you understood this. Let us go to the next point, that is generalization. So generalization is a bottom-up manner. It is opposite to the specialization. Now here in generalization, simply the special categories are grouped into a single category, and that is called as a generalization. Now let us see the diagram. So the same diagram is there, but it will be now explained in bottom-up approach. Now we have entities like officer, teller and secretary. Now Officer is having the attributes as name, street, city, salary, and office number. Tailor is having attributes as name, street, city, salary, station number, and hours worked. Secretary is also having the attributes as name, street, city, salary, and hours worked. Now here you can see that the attributes of officer, tailor, and secretary are almost same. So because of which all these are combined together to give employee. Now here you can see that employee is having the attributes as name, street, city, and salary. Customer is having attributes as name, street, city, and credit rating. So almost three entities are same, because of which generalization can be done and employee and customer can be generally called as a person. I hope you understood. So opposite of specialization is generalization. Now next is attribute inheritance. Now from higher level to lower level, that means from a main entity to subdivided into different entities, all the attributes are inherited. So whatever I was just discussing in the previous slide, so here you can see from person entity to employee entity and to customer entity, name, street, and city are inherited as it is. So this is called as attribute inheritance. So example here given is customer and employee inherit the attributes of person. Thus, customer is described by its name, street, city attributes, and additionally, customer ID is added. And for employee, the employee ID and salary attributes are added. Otherwise, everything is inherited from the main entity, that is person entity. I hope you understood attribute inheritance. So next is constraints on generalization. Now, whenever we are generalizing something, there can be any one of type, that condition defined or result defined. Now here you can see, to model an enterprise more accurately, the database designer may choose to place certain constraints on a particular generalization. One type of constraint involves determining which entities can be member of a given lower entity set. Now, person is having two entities at lower level, that is customer and employee. Now, from the given relation, from the given entity customer, which can be considered as employee is dependent on, is can be handled using two different fields. Now, first one is condition defined and second one is user defined. Now, let us take an example of the same, that person can be an employee. So, person can be employee depending on first condition defined. Now, here we can say that if a customer is there for almost 10 plus years, we can make that particular customer and we can convert that customer into an employee. That is condition defined. Another thing is that the customer is not having 10 years of association with a particular person, but still we can make it, we can make him an employee, because we know that the performance of that particular customer is much, much better, because of which we can make him an employee. I hope you got two different concepts, that is condition defined and user defined. So whenever we are making generalization, the constraint can be given and user defined can be also allowed. Next is aggregation. Now, one limitation to the AIR model is it cannot express relationship among relationships. Now, to see this, what exactly aggregation is, we have to see the diagrams. So let us see the diagram. This is a terminal relationship. So employee works on a branch and employee can be given with a title and level. So employee works for a job whose title is this and level is this. And employee works on a branch. So this ternary relationship is shown so that you will come to know only one relationship set is here, that is works on. Now next diagram is this AIR diagram is with redundant relationships. Now here you can see one more entity is introduced, that is nothing but manager. Now, manager manages everything, means manager manages particular branch, and manager manages an employee or employees of a particular branch. Now, employee again can be associated with an entity named a job. So employee works on job, and branch works on particular job. For that branch, how many levels and how many employees are there, that can also be seen. So this ternary relationship now is having redundant relationship, that is works on relationship and manages relationship. So more than one relationships are shown here. So now by using aggregation, we can combine a particular set of relationship into an entity. So how that is done, let us see on the next diagram. So here you can see employee works on a particular branch and job is considered as one entity, and another entity is manager. So manager manages another entity that contains a ternary relationship. Now we can say manager manages a particular branch, the set of employees working in that particular branch, and the types of designations and levels of all the employees in that particular branch. So this diagram, we call it as ER diagram with aggregation. So in short, I can say a particular relationship is combined together, we call it as an entity. Now this entity is having a relationship with the manager. So manager manages an entity. Entity contains ternary relationship. So this is must to understand it much clearly. So why this is required aggregation? Because such a diagrams, ER diagrams with redundant relationships are confusing, and this particular ER diagram with aggregation seems a little bit simple compared to the redundant relationships. I hope you understood this. The concluding remark for this lecture. So we have seen extended ER features. Up next, the reduction of relation schema that we are going to see. Thank you for listening to the lecture. I hope you understood. You can repeat the video so that you will come to know what exactly these points are. Little bit complicated, but not at all difficult. Slide credit goes to the book, the slide, the book link given here, the Database System Concepts, 7th edition. Thank you very much. Happy learning. Do subscribe the channel to get the new videos. Thank you.